Here's the truth that I'm not afraid to admit on stage today, and that is that I am a work in progress. I'm gonna make mistakes, and I think one of the worst parts is you have to learn lessons over and over and over again before you actually say, oh, I've been here before, I'm gonna do it differently this time. I, in college, would look at other people's timelines, the people that I admired the most. Meredith Vieira, when did she get to the Today Show? How old was she? When did she get married? I looked at these sorts of things as well. How old was she when she got married? I compared myself to other people's timelines and I was always measuring myself up against them. You have to forget what everyone else has been doing. There is no timeline. I don't know how old you all are in here today, but you're here in the perfect time that you're supposed to be here. Despite the ups and downs, we persist. Because even when you are sitting out here and you're working on your businesses and you have these goals, how do you push forward when fear is on your mind, when the chains are weighing you down and they're trying to hold you back? For me, it's uncertainty, knowing that what's gonna happen? I'm a planner and I'm a perfectionist, a recovering perfectionist, to be honest. How do you push all of that aside and still move forward toward your goal? I noticed that any moment that I was anxious, I was really focusing in on what was happening right then, what's happening in that present moment, to get over the anxiety of it. Look back, you've had such a long journey, you have so much more ahead of you, you're gonna get through this. Wanting everything to be just as it is and expecting a lot from yourself. Maybe you're not a perfectionist, but you set high standards for yourself and you are saying, okay, here are my business goals for the next year and I'm going to hit all of these. And if you don't, the conversation in your head, how does it turn, right? It's incredibly negative. I always say, we say things to ourselves that we wouldn't say to our worst enemy. We beat ourselves up over and over and over again in our minds, saying, why did you do that? Why didn't you do this? The way that I came back from all of those struggles with body image was forgiveness, knowing I'm not perfect, admitting I'm perfectly imperfect, and then also moderation. What is it that naturally brings you energy? I wanted to know from him, how do you stay motivated? How do you keep going day after day? He had been in the business for decades. And it's like, what's that thing that gets you up in the morning? And he said, I just love what I do. It brings me a natural energy. I love to get up in the morning and do this. It became my favorite part of the day. I had no trouble waking up at midnight to write because it brought me so much energy. And I finally understood what that CEO said. He said, I wake up and I'm energized to do this because I love it so much. That was the book for me. You control your response. I've learned this lesson the most from my sister. So Christina went out, was picking up one of those stands, was bending over to pick it up, and a bolt of lightning came back from the storm that had passed through. It was a direct strike, so it hit Christina and hit the ground and left a 3-foot deep hole right next to where she was standing. She is still here 19 years later. She has never to this day, though, been able to speak or move on her own since then. So she is a huge inspiration for me. And when I wake up in the morning, as we all do, sometimes we don't have that energy, right? And you're like, I don't really want to go to work today. All I have to do is think of my sister. And I think, you know, for Christina to be able to sit up in bed on her own today would be the best day that she's had in 19 years. You can't not get up and go to work today because my sister is always there. I think there's so much to writing your goals down. I've always been someone who journaled. You can say it, you can write it down, but just going out there and doing it and making it happen. If you want to make a change, do it. And don't just talk about it. Don't just say, oh, I want to do this over and over again. Take action and take silent action. Start it without making some declaration on Facebook or Twitter of what you're doing. Just silently start working on your goals and then wow them when you have the final product.